Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to study about magnitude comparator. Okay, that means I will just compare the magnitude of two bits. Okay, and I will see which one is greater than which one, or which one is less than which one, or which one is equal to which one. Okay, so you can see over here I have taken 2-bit magnitude comparator basically. So this is the generalized diagram of the magnitude comparator circuit where A and B have taken. A may be of 4 bits, maybe 8 bit, B may be 4 bit or 8 bit or 2 bit, okay, whatever. So that's why I have given n, small n. Okay, so n is the number of bits, right? So when you pass it to this circuit, it will say me whether it's f1, f2 or f3. What is f1? F1 says that if A is greater than B, then f1 light LED will glow. If A is equal to B, f2 light LED will glow, and if A is less than B, then f3 LED will glow. So there is a function I've written over here. F1 equals to 1 if A is greater than B, f2 equals to 1 if A is equals to B, f3 equals to 1 if A is less than B. So this is generalized form. Okay, so I'm assuming a 2 bit for A and 2 bit for B. Okay, and I will try to compare it out. So 2-bit magnitude comparator, the concept which I'm going to discuss over here will lies for 3-bit also, 4-bit also, whatever the structure may be. Okay, so I've taken 2-bit over here, I'm trying to explain that, right? So A2, A1, B2, B1 I have taken, and I'm passing through this comparator circuit, so it will give me F1, F2 and F3. And you know by this time what is F1, F2 and F3. This is A is greater than B, this is A is equals to B, and this is A is less than B, right? So I've written the same thing over here, and now I'm designing the table, that is A2, A1, B2, B1, F1, F2 and F3. So what I will do, A2, A1 means 0, 0 I will take. So what exactly the process is, for 0, 0 of A2, A1, I have to take all the first possible values of B2, B1. Okay, then again the value of A2, A1 I will take, again 4 possible values of B2, B1, because 2 to the power 2 is 4, 2 variable I am taking, right? So 2 to the power 2 is 4, so 4 combination of B I will get. So for each combination of A, I will compare with 4 combination of B, and accordingly I will find out the value of F1, F2 and F3. So you see the first combination is 0, so 4 times I have taken 0, okay, and I have changed the value of B, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay, and I have tested that with F1, F2 and F3. Second, you can see 0, 1 I have taken 4 times, and I have compared with all the 4 combination of B. That is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Similarly, for third, that is 1, 0. Okay, over here third, but basically it is 0, 1, 2, so it is 2. Okay, 4 combination, then for 3, 4 combinations I have taken. Now, let us see the value of F1, F2, F3. Now, see over here, it is 0, 0, this is 0, 0. Okay, so this is equal, so F2 is equal and this 2 are 0. Now 0 0 0 1, so A is less than B, so F3 is 1, this 2 are 0. Now it is 0 0 1 0, so obviously A is less than B. Okay, so F3 is coming as 1, this 2 are coming as 0. So over here you can see A is again 0 0, this is 1, so A is less than B, so F3 is coming as 1, this 2 are coming as 0. Come to the next part, this is 0 1, this is 0 0, so A is greater than B, so you can see F1 is coming as 1, this 2 are 0. Accordingly, second one 0 1 0 1, both are equal, so F2 is 1, this is 0, this is 0. Now 0 1 1 0, now you can see this is 1, this is 2, so B is greater than A, that is A is less than B, right? So you can see this is 1, okay, this 2 are 0. Finally 0 1 1 1, so B is greater. Okay, so A is you can see A is less than B or B is greater, so B is, since B is greater, okay, we are finding F3 as 1 because we have written that A is less than B or B is greater than A. Okay, so this is 1. Accordingly, I have checked for this part and this part, and I got the table for F1, F2 and F3. Now I'll design the KMF for F1, F2, F3 depending upon the variable A2, A1, B2, B1. So you can see the first one I have taken A2, A1, B2, B1, and this 4 variable KMF. The empty box is filled with 0, I have not filled it, okay. So I've just taken the values from here. So wherever 1 is there, I've taken and I implemented in the graph. And then I'm finding what? This is a quad I'm finding, this is a pair I'm finding, and this is again a pair I'm finding. So accordingly, I got this equation for F1. Okay, similarly for F2 also I have taken A2, A1, B2, B1, and from F2 from here I have taken the ones I implemented over here, I got the equation, this one. Okay, this further I have reduced the equation, and I'm getting A1 XOR B1 into A2 XOR B2. Okay, now for F3 also I have taken the same thing, I have taken the values from here, implement the map, and I'm finding one quad, one pair and two pair. So accordingly I got the equation. Now depending on the equation, I've designed the circuit over here. You can see, to make the circuit easy, you take in this way A2, A1, B2, B1. Don't make it clumsy. So just like multiplexer, A2, A1 straight line I have taken, and then I implement the circuit. For F1 you can see A2, B bar. So I have taken A2 from here, B2 over here, and I have given a NOT gate. This is A2, B bar. Then I have taken A1, B2 bar and B1 bar. You can see A1 from here, v2 bar from here and v1 bar from here. Finally, I have taken a2 from here, okay, I have taken a1, this one, okay, and I have taken b1 bar, and all are odd together, this function is f1. Similarly, I have done for f2 and f3. Okay, so this is a circuit which I have designed, okay, basing on this table and the equation, okay, will be giving me 2-bit magnitude comparator. So same concept you can apply for higher version of computer also. Okay, thank you for watching my video.